Assessment of Communication and Interaction Skills, or ACES.
ACES was established in 1998 at University of Illinois at Chicago Department of Occupational Therapy. ACES was developed within the model of Human Occupation Moho. There are several versions of ACES, which are English version 4.0, English version 3.2, Swedish version ACES-S, Norwegian version ACES, and Chinese version ACES-C. The developer of ACES are Dr. Sandy Simon, Dr. Marcel Salami, and Professor Kirsty Forsyth. They are all an occupational therapist. Next is the purpose of ACES. First, ACES is an observational rating skill designed to capture in detail a person's social interactional ability while he or she is participating in a meaningful social context. Second, to identify areas of strength and habits interfering with effective interaction. And third, to assess clients' capacities to express themselves and to interact with others. ACES is a clinician-rated assessment, and the total administration time for ACES is within 20 to 60 minutes, as observation time takes 15 to 45 minutes and rating time takes 15 to 20 minutes. Next is the target population of ACES. The age range is within 16 to 87 years old from adolescent and adult, and the indication is for people with mental illness or any diagnosis that interferes with communication and interaction functioning, such as people with intellectual disabilities.
Next is contraindication. This assessment cannot be used in client with severe cognitive impairment, client with unmanaged substance abuse, and client with psychosis.
ACES consists of 3 domains and 20 skills. The first domain are physicality, that consists of 6 skills, which are context, gazes, gestures, maneuvers, orients, and posture. The second domain is information exchange, with 9 skills, which are articulates, asserts, asks, engage, expresses, modulates, shares, speaks, and sustains. And the third domain is relations, with 5 skills, which are collaborates, conforms, focuses, relates, and respects.
For administration procedure, the therapist will introduce the assessment to the client and explain on the purpose and importance of the assessment.
Assalamualaikum, Miss.
Waalaikumsalam.
How are you today? Okay, my name is Ain. I am your therapist today. So today I'm going to conduct assessment of communication and interaction skills. So the purpose of me doing this assessment to you is to capture in detail your social interaction ability while you are participating in a meaningful social context, because I want to see your capacities in expressing yourself while interacting with other people. So this assessment contains 3 domains that I will observe, which are physicality, information exchange, and relations.
Then, the client will work with the therapist to choose any social settings that the client wish to participate in.
So Miss, can you tell me what kind of social activities do you wish to participate in that you think are motivating and meaningful to you?
I wish I could freely chat with my friend.
Next, the therapist will then observe the clients in the chosen settings and take note.
General scoring for ACES. 4 indicates competent, which means the patient has skill that is performed to support ongoing social action. 3 questionable, which means mastery of the skill to the extent that it supports ongoing social action is questionable. 2 is ineffective, which means there is a lack of the skill to the extent that it interferes with social action. And 1 indicate deficits, which means skill is severely deficient to the extent that it causes a breakdown of social interaction. ACES is an observational tool. Therefore, the therapists have to score what they see and not make inferences as to why there may be difficulties. The rating is scored based on the presence or severity of difficulty of the skills as defined. The therapist will rate the client on the 20 ACES skills using the 4-point Likert scale. Score interpretation of ACES. Each rating reflects the extent to which the observed skill supports or hinders the flow and completion of the activity, as well as the ongoing social interaction. The closer the score to 80 indicate good communication and interaction skill.
Okay, Miss, from the social settings that I had observed from you earlier, your total score is 37 out of 80. From this, I conclude that unfortunately, your communication and interaction skills are poor. So after a few treatments, I will do reassessment to see if there is any difference. That is all from me. Thank you for your participation.
Psychometric properties of ACES. Under reliability, there are test-retest reliability and inter-rater reliability, while under validity, there are phase validity, construct validity, and criterion convergent validity. Test-retest reliability. The intra-class correlation coefficient measure is 0.92, and the total skill score is considered almost perfect. For physicality, the ICC measured is 0.99, also almost perfect. For information exchange, ICC measured is 0.76, considered as strong, and 0.80 for relations, also considered as strong. Inter-rater reliability. Simon's study of inter-rater reliability of the first version of ACES indicated that most skill items had moderate reliability, but some could not be scored reliably. Phase validity.
ASSIS assessment has been conducted to many different kinds of population research and has been proven understandable and relevant to the target population. The psychometric study of ASSIS had a more extensive scope and it indicated a good level of psychometric properties among the raters using ASSIS. Construct validity. The arrangements of the calibrated skill items in an order that makes clinical sense supports construct validity. The easiest items were those that reflect simple movements, passively going along with social norms, and production of clear understandable words. The harder skill items were more sophisticated communication behaviors, including entering into and sustaining a conversation and accommodating for one's own communication and interaction deficits. Criterion validity for convergence. An expert panel of occupational therapists served as raters and clients with learning disabilities and mental health problems were assessed. 60% of the skill items from ASSIS were found to be equivalent to items in ICIDH2. In total, 41% of the items in AMPS or ASSIS have a correlation higher than 0.60, which considered strong with ICIDH2. Advantages of ASSIS. First, ASSIS provides simple instruction and less equipment needed, and it also can observe person's strengths and weaknesses in real social context. Third, ASSIS is easy to administer and also works in Eastern language and cultural context. It also not diagnostically bound and can be used to people that has interferes with communication and interaction functioning. Next is ASSIS disadvantages. First, the scoring of ASSIS is based on observer judgment, and administration duration may take time, which is within 20 to 60 minutes. Also, the therapist's level of engagement during the activity may impact on what they observe, and the ASSIS procedure may be emotionally challenging for novice assessors. In terms of suitability to be used with Malaysian population, this assessment is suitable to be used with Malaysian population because all the domains and skills to be assessed are appropriate and relevant. However, for contact skill under domain physicality, it is only appropriate for Muslim clients to make physical contact with the same gender.